Welcome to the first episode in creating a trans track from scratch for beginners in Ableton Live 10. I'm actually recording this episode at last, but it will be the first in this series because I have to say some things about this course before you start watching this course. So what we are going to do in this course is to create an entire trance track. You can see it in the screen. This is the track. And the track is finished right now. And this is what we are going to make. And in some of the videos, you will hear me say that I only want to use Ableton Live 10 plugins. But at some point in the series, I digress from that, especially in the mixing stage and in the mastering stage, I digress from it. And I started to use some extra plugins, external plugins like Neutron 2 Advanced and Ozone 8 Advanced. And if you don't have these plugins, then don't worry. I think you can still follow this course and use your own plugins. But I think it's a good point to make is that for beginners, these are really good plugins. They can really help you understand the mixing. And if you really understand these plugins well, then you can come along a far distance. So I've made the track already, and also what I have to say is that this is my first course series I made on YouTube. So there are a lot of things I need to improve. It's not perfect. There's even a video which has no audio, so it's kind of a mess, maybe you think. So maybe you don't like watching this. If so, then wait, because I'm going to make a new series, and hopefully then everything will be better, because it will be my second time creating a series on creating trance music. Okay, and what I further want to do in this episode is I want to play this entire track. It's mastered in Ozone 8, and I will now let's play this track. And from that point onwards, you can enjoy the series, or as I said earlier, if you want to have a better experience, a better series with higher quality content, then wait a bit and see my next course, which will appear soon. So let's have a listen to the entire track after it is finished. We'll be right back. Okay, so that was the track. I hope you liked it. It's not perfect, but I'm also not a very professional producer, of course, but I think it sounds nice, at least. And in the next episodes, you can see me making this track. As I said, there will be some messy things in it, that sometimes the audio is not working, that I'm doing things for the fifth times and it still isn't working. Okay, it's not perfect, but in the next series I try to make it more perfect, and hopefully you can still learn from this series. And if you have any comments or questions, leave them down below. Thank you all for watching, and hope to see you also in the next course. Bye bye.